On this tutorial, I will show you how to play GoldenEye XBLA on your Xbox One or Series without the need to use developer mode, which is what I had to do here a few weeks ago on my Series X, and I show you how to do it in the description. However, if you are here, you prefer retail mode, which is why I'm making this tutorial right now. The first thing you have to do is download the game, but you have to keep in mind that there's two versions you must avoid, one of them being the retail version, which is a single file full of numbers. It's compressed and we cannot use it, and the second one being the original November 2007 build, which has an assets folder on it. We cannot use it either, so don't download any of these. Once you get the proper one, which is simply called GoldenEye 007 XBLA, it will have a bin folder and inside the files folder. Once you get this, all you have to do is get the community edition updater, which is found here, linked in the description. Scroll down and click here, where it says download the zip file. You will get the zip file, which I have right here. Then you just have to open the bin folder and drag and drop CE update inside the bin folder we had before. Once that's done, you can close the zip file, open the CE update folder, and click on this patch file. Click on more info, run anyway, and then just follow what it says here, which is press any key to continue. Press the key, and it's finished. Press again, and you will notice that now when you go back, you will have the files CE folder and a bunch of folders with CE on their name as well. And this one will be the most important, as it will be the one we use to launch the game on Xbox. Once that's finished, you have to ready up your USB drive to use on your Xbox. You will have to use this program, which is also linked in the description. Scroll down here and choose the version that fits your PC. In my case, x64.zip. I already have it downloaded, so all I have to do is open the .exe file right here, click on yes, and now here you have to choose your USB drive from the list on the left. Make sure to choose the correct one because everything will be deleted. Mine here is already called Xbox Media USB v2 because I already did this, but I'm gonna do it again anyway. Click on format USB, all data on this drive will be erased, click on yes. Wait a few seconds. Drive is now prepared for your Xbox. Click OK. Close it. And now all you have to do is copy the bin folder we just patched a few minutes ago onto the USB drive. Drag and drop this. And just wait for this to complete. When that's complete, all you have to do now is join the Discord server that I've linked in the description. You will see something like this. Go to rules and read everything so you don't get banned. Then go to retail app status and you will see a check mark like this one. This means you can download everything just fine, but if you see one of these two signs, it means you have to wait until they are re-uploaded. If you see the check mark, head over to retail announcements, scroll up, and you will see all the links here. Here's Xenia emulator and the link itself. I will block out the links here because I can assure you 100% that by the time you are seeing this, they will be different than the ones I'm using. They keep getting taken down and re-uploaded all the time, so you really have to check by yourself. Now on the Xbox, you have to go to the browser. I have mine right here because I used it recently, but if you don't see it here, go to the search bar and type in Edge, and it should be the first result. Here it is. And now you have to type in manually the link from Discord. After that, you will get this message asking you to open the Microsoft Store. Just click on open. You will be taken to this page and just follow everything as you normally would with any other app. It's a random name just so they don't take it down instantly, I guess. And remember to launch it right away after it's downloaded, so that your license activates and you can launch it even if they take it down. If you don't do that and they take it down, you won't be able to play. Go back home, and there it is, just launch it. And here you have to go to the Paths tab at the top. Go to Add Path, and here choose your USB drive from the left, open the folder, and then select. Go back to the game list, And here you will see three games: Bean, Default CE, and Default CE Surround. Default CE is the one you want to launch to have the patched game. If you launch Bean, you will launch the unpatched game without any of the fixes. So just press A on Default CE and wait for it to load. The first time you launch the game will take a long while, but also keep in mind that my USB is really slow and takes even longer. So if you use a modern USB drive or hard drive or anything, it will be much faster. However, we are not done yet. There's a few more settings you have to change in game. As you can see, the image is stretched, and we do not want that. Go to Help and Options, then Other Settings, and set the screen ratio to 16:9. Here you can also increase the volume of both sliders to the maximum, and then go back, Control Settings, disable Look Ahead, auto aim, and set the look up down setting to upright. Of course, that's personal preference, but I recommend doing that. Maybe not the auto aim, but yeah. After that, you are free to play the full game start to finish. As you can see, there's still some stuttering, but that's completely normal. For the first few minutes, you will experience that, but then it will be all smooth. Keep in mind, the emulator has to compile all the shaders that you play at first. As you can see here, I will switch to the N64 graphics. It hangs for a second, but then I can go back and forth freely without any stuttering. After a few minutes, you will be playing the game at 60fps without any problems. As you can see, the game is fully playable start to finish, including local multiplayer. If you run into any issues, please leave a comment below and I will try to help you. I hope you find this tutorial helpful and can finally enjoy the proper remaster we should have got, instead of the lazy, almost non-functional re-release we got in its place.